वेलकम टू फायर्स एजुकेशनल वीडियो सीरीज। इन दिस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ आवर डिस्कशन ऑन टेक्निकल एनालिसिस। बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल नो द बेसिक्स ऑफ सपोर्ट, द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ सपोर्ट एंड हाउ डू आइडेंटिफाई अ सपोर्ट on the chart. You will frequently read or hear traders and market technicians say something like, I expect the price to hold this level and resume its rally. Or something like, if this level breaks, then the price could witness continued selling pressure. What do they mean when they use words such as level or zone? Well, in the context of technical analysis, when traders and market technicians use words such as level or zone, they are mostly referring to one of support or resistance. Well, let us now start talking about these vital concepts. Support and resistance are, by far, two of the most used words in technical analysis. In fact, support and resistance are the building blocks upon which various concepts related to charting and chart patterns are based upon. But what exactly are supports and resistances? Although we will talk about each of these concepts in much greater detail in this video and in the next, for now, just keep in mind that support and resistances are levels on a chart where the market forces of demand and supply interact. Support and resistance help a trader or a technician in understanding the psychology of market participants in general. Because support and resistance form the base of technical analysis, it is important to have a strong understanding of these terms and know how to identify them effectively and efficiently on charts. In this video, we shall talk about support and take up resistance in the next video. A support is nothing but a region on the chart where one can expect demand to absorb all the available supply, causing the price decline to halt and for the price to turn higher. Put it in simple words, a support is a level where demand is likely to outweigh supply, causing price to turn higher. Let us understand this using the chart here. In this chart, from point 1, notice that price rallied till point 2 from where it started falling. This decline from point 2 ended at point 3. Before price started climbing again. Now, if you closely observe, you will notice that point 3 terminated at essentially the same level as point 1 before starting the up. Here, point 1 acted as a support to the price at point 3. You can think of support as a former level that acts as a floor to the price in future. In a similar manner, notice that 0.5 stopped right near the vicinity of 0.3 and 0.1. Here, both these former points acted as supports or as a floor to the price at 0.5 before the up move began from 0.5. This is what a support is. it is a previous price low on the chart where the price decline halted and the price moved higher. You may wonder, why do prior supports hold? Well, to understand this, let us think behind the psychology of market participants, that is, buyers and sellers. But before that, let us revisit the basics of demand and supply. Keep in mind that when buyers are more aggressive than sellers, the price will tend to rise. When sellers are more aggressive than buyers, the price will tend to decline. And when buyers and sellers are in equilibrium, price will tend to move in a sideways fashion. Let us now answer the question as to why do prior supports hold. For doing so, let us use the same example that we used earlier. Price topping out at 0.2 and starting to move lower from there tells the chartist that sellers are being more aggressive than buyers, which is causing the price to decline. However, by the time the price declines from 0.2 and approaches towards the prior low of 0.1, it would have become cheaper. This would make buying more attractive and selling less attractive, causing demand to potentially outstrip supply and help price in reversing higher. In other words, when price is at 0.3, which is near the vicinity of a prior low, the buyers will be more attracted to buy as the price of the security is cheaper, while the sellers will be less inclined to sell because of lower prices. Also, buyers who had missed the boat to buy when the price of the security was at 0.1, or buyers who had bought at 0.1 and now want to buy more on subsequent price corrections would be more than willing to buy the security as and when the price falls back towards the 0.1. This also causes demand to increase on subsequent retest of a prior low or a prior support. Similarly, at 0.5, as the price is near a previous low and is cheaper than at 0.4, it would increase the demand for the security and reduce the aggressiveness of sellers to sell, in turn causing the decline to halt and for the price to turn higher. When learning and applying the principles of technical analysis, always keep in mind that technical analysis is more an art than a science. What this means is, one must not stick to hard and fast rules, but must rather be open and flexible in their approach towards analyzing and interpreting charts. Let us explain this using the example of a support. When looking at a prior support, do not just look at the precise low of that support. Instead, be flexible in your approach. Do not ignore a support just because it has been penetrated by a small margin. Often, it just so happens that a prior support is broken by a small margin before the price eventually bottomed out and started to move higher. In such a case, the support remains very much intact. Occasionally, when two or more previous lows coincide close to each other, one could draw a support zone rather than a support line and extend that zone to the right in order to find out the potential area that could act as a support going forward. To understand the concept of a support zone better, have a look at this chart. See that the decline from 0.2 extended slightly beyond the low of 0.1. However, see that there was no follow-through selling. Instead, the price bottomed out at 0.3 and started moving higher from there on. In this case, also, although the prior support at 0.1 was broken, keep in mind that the selling did not materialize and the price reversed higher, thereby keeping the support at 0.1 intact. Meanwhile, as the price started declining from 0.4, you may wonder which support to focus on going forward. 0.1 or the support at 0.3? Well, in this case, because the lows at 0.1 and 0.3 are very close to each other, it would be better to draw a zone between the low at 0.1 and the low at 0.3. What we now have is a support zone rather than a support line. As price declines from 0.4, you can expect support to be found somewhere around this support zone and a possible move higher from there. Hence, in cases where more than one support confluence close to each other, it would be better to draw a support zone and focus on that zone going forward. Up until now, what we saw was a former low or a zone of lows providing support to price. That said, do not presume that a former support or a support zone would always hold. Previous supports can and do break going forward in time. And when they do, it indicates continued selling pressure until the next level of support is reached. To understand this more effectively, again think the psychology of market participants. Near a previous support, it is expected that demand will be strong enough to absorb the supply and cause price to start heading higher. However, when a support breaks and selling persists, it indicates that sellers are willing to sell at further depressed prices and that the buying pressure is not strong enough to absorb all the available supply and halt the decline in price. Moreover, buyers who had bought at the support in anticipation that price would start heading higher from there would be caught on the wrong side of the trade when the support level has broken. Sensing this, they may try to exit from their buy positions, which could add to more pressure on price. Hence, when a support level is broken, it is not uncommon to see price declining further until the next level of support is reached. In the case of this chart here, the next support is the one that appears on the far left of the chart. Let us now conclude what all we have spoken thus far regarding support. A support is one of the two most critical concepts in technical analysis, the other being a resistance. A support is a previous low or a confluence of two or more lows if they are cluttered close to each other. You can think of support as a level or a zone that offers a floor to the price, that is, a prior region where demand can be expected to absorb all the available supply. A support can appear anywhere on the chart up to the current market price of a security. That is, a support could either be at or below the current price of a security. An important point to remember is that a support is not infallible or impenetrable. When the price approaches a support, one of the two things could happen. Number one, the support could hold and the price could start moving higher. Or number two, the support could break and the price could continue its decline until the next support area is reached. Hence, it becomes very critical to closely observe how price trades near a support level or a support zone before deciding to act. Well, that was all that we wanted to cover in this video. If you liked our video, do not forget to click on the like button below. Also, hit the subscribe button to subscribe to our YouTube channel and the bell icon to receive regular updates about new videos. Thank you for watching this video.